Macra na Firma Radio Drama 2021 competition entry from Limerick Macra. Ballylanders Macra presents Committee Meetings Are Boring, written by Siobhan Dunne and performed by Alice Daly, Denise Murphy, Grace O'Gorman, Liam O'Donoghue, John Joe Daly, John Hennessy, Pat Ryan, Peter Maloney, and Siobhan Dunne. In a small village on the border of County Mayo, many different groups make use of the community center. The Parish Development Group is meeting to discuss some local matters and to make plans. So, is everyone here?
I think that's everyone, Sarah. Julie sent her apologies. Cow calving, you know the time of year and all.
Was hoping we'd have a few more, but sure, we'll get started so. Anyone else can just join in when they arrive. Denny, can you get the doors there? So has everybody got a copy of the agenda? Anything to be added? No? Grand, so, meeting of the Parish Development Committee opened at 9 p.m. Mary, if you could read the minutes of the last meeting.
Last meeting was held on the 7th of January. In attendance were Sarah, Mary, Julie, Denny and Joel. Apologies from Nora and Paul. The meeting was opened by the Chair, Sarah, and minutes by Mary. The main business, the treasurer, Julie reported lodgement of Christmas raffle monies, and prize winners were to be contacted for promotions in the local papers. Over €500 was raised for the village park. Well done to all for their hard work selling tickets. The local Macra club were in touch about holding a tractor run to raise money for Boher. Something about a calf, and it was agreed to allow the use of the parish hall on the 23rd of January. Denny would open up and lock up afterwards. They should be done by 4 p.m. The ladies' football club is running an event for Valentine's night and were to be contacted about the hall again to confirm times by the secretary. In any other business, we agreed to add St. Patrick's Day parade to the agenda for the next meeting. The gates of the village park were to be checked by Denny to make sure there is no loitering after hours. Oh, and the werewolves were to be added to the February agenda also. The next meeting is set for the 7th of February and meeting closed at 9 p.m.
Propose and second?
I propose.
Second.
Matters rising. Christmas hampers were given out there before Christmas. Nice photo in the paper this week and on Facebook. I haven't been on Instagram. A note went into the parish newsletter to thank everyone for their support.
Father Tracy read it out on Sunday. 'Twas very nice.
Denny, how'd the tractor run go?
No bother. They were in and out, except for Julie's old yoke. You know what they say, if it's not red, keep it in the shade.
No, that's a different meeting. Mary, did the ladies' football get back with a time?
Yeah, they want to be in to set up from 6 p.m. They should be done by 2 a.m. if the DJ is on track.
You okay to do those times, Denny?
I'll be there anyways. Should be good night too. They're getting Father Tracy to hold blind dates this time. The blind leading the blind, eh?
Sorted, so on to the next item, treasurer's report. We've no Julie tonight. She sent a text with the balance. Mary, we'll get a full report next meeting. What's next?
The St. Patrick's Day parade.
Right, we'll need to contact the usual clubs, see who's entering what and who we can get to help out directing traffic.
Judges?
I can contact Nora and Dermot to judge. Mary, can you ask Father Tracy again?
No problem. He'll be running the yoga here tomorrow evening anyway.
Grand. Who else do we need to contact?
Same as last year about the roads. I can handle that too.
Perfect. On to the next topic, so.
The werewolves?
Hurroo! So we were proposing setting up another group like they did in Swindon, with their militia to deal with them. They've been getting out of hand lately.
Yeah, they were up causing mischief by the GA field the other night. My brother had to chase them off with her. The feckers.
They keep stealing our corner flags.
And going against the goals. This desperate cheek. With children up there using those pitches, and it's just not on.
Yes, we've had a few complaints from parents, all right.
They were rooting up the hedges in the village park last week, and they knocked over the bug hotel the school made.
I remember the last time they were causing this much trouble. We had to set fire to the whole...
We're not doing that again.
What if we get Father Tracy to say a mass for them?
We tried that before, all right. We'd need an old priest and a young priest, I think. Oh, and the moon has to be in alignment with Aquarius. It should be in the minutes from the last time it was done.
Well, we can try the mass again, but we should see if we can get a few volunteers for to help out anyways. The GA teams in the Macra are usually good for that. Joe, can you talk to the hurlers? We'll ask Julie to see about the Macra.
I'll say it to the yoga group tomorrow too, and ask Father Tracy to pass it on to the men's shed on Friday.
Then we'll just need to dig out some blessed silver, and we'll be sorted. When is the next full moon anyways?
3 weeks' time. It's on a Friday night.
Grand. Sure, we'll have another meeting in 2 weeks anyways, and we can finalise things then. So, volunteers, silver, and Father Tracy to say a mass. Might get him to bless the silver then too, actually. Was there anything else?
No, I think that's everything. Need to add Easter egg hunt to the agenda for the next meeting too.
Good, yeah. Don't need a repeat of last year's fiasco.
That wasn't my fault, no. Young Billy highly provoked those hens.
Sure, Joe, sure. It was unlucky. Just better to be prepared this year.
There's another group in after us to use the hall tonight.
You Jesus. Fucking hens.
We'll wrap up, so. Next meeting?
2 weeks' time on the 25th? I'll put it up in the WhatsApp.
Perfect. Meeting closed.
Heading it. Who's in after us tonight?
It's another fitness group. Natural ethics or something.
What's that when it's at home?
Some sort of exercise. With nature, I think. Or ethics, or both. Not sure, really. It's not a nudist group. I checked this time.
It better not be. Once was enough for that to happen. I swear I could have died when I heard about it from Father Tracy afterwards.
I think the rest of the set dancers loved it. My mum still goes on about it sometimes.
Yeah, they always turn up early since that night.
Come on, we better get going and let the next group in.
See you
right,
next time.
See ya, bye, sound.
Good night.
Hi, Denny. Thanks for letting us use the hall. We should be done by 10.
Grandso, you know where everything is. Kitchen is in the left door there, and the bathrooms are down the hall on the right. I'll get the lights for them now. Do you need anything else set up?
No, we're grand. Just need some floor space. It's a bit too cold to be training outdoors for now. It's more of an intro night tonight anyways. So nothing wild. Only expecting a small group. Hopefully we'll get a few more though next week.
Hey Alex, Denny. Kiera said she'd be a bit late. She's given Julie a hand with the cows.
Okay, Billy. Tell me you brought the speakers.
Yeah, got them here. That weird singing again this time.
It sets the mood, okay? Just pick a spot, so, and start warming up.
You joining us tonight, Denny?
No. I'll let you at it. I'll be back to lock up about 10, so.
Perfect. See you then.
How are you, Connor?
Hi, Denny. Grand shirt, tipping away.
Say hi to your parents for me.
No bother. See you again. He's gone. Can we cut the music?
Still waiting on Kiera. And I like it. Sets the mood.
Sorry I'm late. Did I miss anything?
Hey, Kiera.
No, your grand. Will you lock the door there behind you and we'll get started. So, Billy, Any update on the flags?
No update yet. The GAA club are minding them now. They chased me off with a hurley yesterday. I've got a massive bruise in my arm.
Did he?
My arm? What do you think I was going to say, Connor? Jeez.
You know we need those flags to break the curse. Kiera, will you give him a hand the next time?
Cool, we'll get it done. What else do we need?
Well, we took care of the Easter eggs last year, so just need to get them on the St. Patrick's Day float with the flags, I think.
Good stuff. So, what'll we do for the float to hide the rest of it?
The Macra are doing the storm again this year, so can't go with that. What about the election?
No, it'll be like the year Trump was running and everyone and their dogs did the building of a wall thing. Remember, the Mexicans.
That was hilarious.
Will we just go with St. Patrick versus the snakes or something? Minimal effort. We just need to do the route through the village for the ritual this time, and we don't want to be kicked out of it for something silly.
Political correctness gone mad. Can we do it like a cage fight? I'll be St. Patrick.
You just want to show off. It's March, remember, but that will be pretty funny.
Have we got a trailer first? Kiera?
Yeah, should be okay. I'll check with the brother.
Okay, we'll go with that. Get those flags for the next week. But for now, let's get some practice in before Denny comes back to lock up.
As a reminder, you are all welcome to join my class at any time that aligns with your trajectory in the universe. I only write the time in the schedule as a spiritual guide. Just another reminder, this class is donation based and funds raised go to the repair of the church roof. Now reach into the air, look to the clouds, inhale, exhale, look to the floor, and bind if you can. My guess is that you're not actually thirsty, Mrs. O'Shea, but that you're avoiding doing the pose, and that is a great act of listening to the body and mind, and it notifies us of what kind of people we are. And exhale into the downward facing dog, knees slightly bent, tailbone to the sky, then come forward into our chaturanga. Now for those of us doing actual yoga, we're going to lower from our chaturanga into our cobra pose. If this is hard for you, remember, notice it. Don't judge it. Breathe. Don't judge it. Just notice it's everyone's different. Now back up onto your downward facing dog. Onto our next inhale, we take our foot to the top of the mat for warrior one. Beautiful. Mrs. Ryan, your insistence on breathing the loudest really notifies everyone in the room how experienced you are in the practice of yoga. Thank you. Now, whenever we're ready, we'll find our way back to the downward facing dog and finish off our vinyasa flow by coming down into the mesh, hands joined in prayer pose. We're going to end with some breathing exercises, and we're going to breathe in love and breathe out ego. I'd like to finish off today's class by reminding everyone that yoga is not a competition. The most important thing is to not judge yourself. Notice it, but don't judge it, okay? Everyone's different. This is a mixed level class, so some of us are more advanced and some of us are obviously very terrible. I want to thank you all again for taking the effort to come here today and for sharing your yoga practice with me. I look forward to seeing some of you next week, as well as many of you in the coming months, when the shame of your lifestyle choices becomes overwhelming and you decide to make a small, temporary, non-committal lifestyle change. But remember, the most important thing is not to judge yourself. That's my job. Namaste.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Very good, ladies and gents. Hope you enjoyed the class.
Thanks, Father. It was a lot tougher than that laughter yoga last week.
Yeah, that was a pretty mean workout, Father Tracy.
Yes. Not sure if angry yoga is my calling, but so long as you enjoy it. That's why I tried those new online courses. But it's hard to beat the live class.
Thanks again, Father. We'll see you next week.
Father Tracy, if you have a moment?
Sure, Mary. How can I help you?
Well, we had the community meeting last night and we're hoping you could judge the St. Patrick's Day parade this year.
I'd be happy to. It was so colourful last year.
If it's not too much trouble, we were hoping you could do another mass for the werewolves too.
That was a marvellous idea. Everyone knows that werewolves love a good mass.
That is true, and you do a lovely sermon, Father.
Thank you. It's always good to hear. I'll check the diary back in the church and we'll pencil it in. Need to do it properly. Will we be blessing some silver too?
Well, that would be for the best, Father.
Grand, grand. Anything else?
Oh, yes. We're looking for a few volunteers to help out with dealing with some of the young pups causing trouble by the GA pitch. Can you pass it on to the men's shed group next time?
That should be no bother. Kids these days with their basketball and their TikToks. We'll get it sorted. Don't worry.
Hold up a sec. Give me the ball. When you're playing into County hurling, it's all about the percentages. There's about 7 or 8 of you after getting the ball. By the time you get to here, you should be stopping here, okay? So you need to be nice and tight. Leg down, turn, and gone, okay? Back in the line, ladies. Can I have a ball? Okay, we can do one more drill before we go into a game, okay? So we're heading out. Jab lift the ball. Number one, get position. Number two, take your 4 steps. Number three, shorten the hurl. Have a look. Pop it into her hand. Remember, when you come out to the ball, come out like a train. Last yard, slow down a bit. Touch one hand and gone. But don't forget your 4 steps, okay? Go. Go. Nice and tidy. Nice and tidy. That's it. Have a look now. Have a look. That's it. Good ball. Back. Nuala, eye on the ball. Focus.
But coach, there's someone at the corner flags there.
Not again. Those bloody wolves. Give me the ball.
He's taking the flag.
Oh no, he's not. Get him, girls.
Oh, coach, I think he's gone, coach.
Flags are gone too.
Thanks again, Denny. See you at 10.
See you later, lads. Be good.
Hi, Connor, Billy. Sorry I'm late.
No worries.
Great. We have a few more coming tonight, so we'll give it another few minutes. Is Denny gone?
Yep, your music drives him off every time. Oh, there's Mary and Kiera, no? Is that Father Tracy I see with them?
It's probably about the mass Mary was on about.
I do love a good mass.
Don't we all?
How are you, Father? Mary? Kiera? Good you made it.
We can get started, so. Father, did you want to talk about the mass first?
Yes, perfect. There's a full moon next week, so I wanted to check if that would suit all of you.
That's before St. Patrick's Day, isn't it? That should be fine, I think.
Would some of you like to say prayers of the faithful for me? Or are there any particular readings you would like to do?
I'm sure we can do the prayers. You're probably the best to pick readings for this, though.
No problem. Can go with the same as last time, so I think.
That should be perfect, Father.
I better let ye at it, so. Have a good night. Before I forget, a note was sent into the parish newsletter about an outbreak of fleas in the area, so I'd recommend staying away from the local docks.
Thank you, Father. I'll put that up in the community WhatsApp too.
Well, that's something to look forward to now. Back to St. Patrick's Day. Billy, Kiera, how'd you get on?
Took a bit of effort, but we got them.
Yeah, Billy distracted the GAA crew while I grabbed the flags. Joe was mad, but the under-14's camogie team is really shaping up. Their aim's improved a lot since the last time I saw them.
Tell me about it. They're vicious too. I pity any team that plays them.
That's great work. Finally, we have everything we need to break the curse. It's hard to believe. We just need to get it through the St. Patrick's Day parade route and it'll be done at last.
What are you doing for the parade? The Macra are doing the storm again, apparently. Not sure which one this time. There's a few other new groups this year too, so it won't be too bad.
We'll just keep it simple and non-threatening.
St. Patrick, cage fighting with some snakes. I'll be St. Patrick.
No, seriously.
How about going with fake news or something like that?
I can't stand that guy. Wasn't there enough of him to time with the wall and now he's picking a fight with China? How about the old ways are best? We could put some Kelly music on the speakers.
I'll be St. Patrick. I can DJ.
Kiera, do we have speakers?
I'll get it sorted.
I like the old ways are best. It's straightforward. We'll have the flags anyway, and the eggs, so we just need something to cover that and fill space. Could do with a few more bodies on it.
I'll see if the sisters will do it. It's a very good cause, like.
Good, good. Sure, it's a week away yet. We can see about it after the mass.
I already have the St. Patrick's costume, though.
We're not doing a cage-fighting scene. But you can wear it anyway. Now, we'd better get some training in again.
Can't wait till we can practice outside again. It's just not the same.
There's a fine stretch coming in the evenings, at last. Should be back out in a few weeks.
Well, we're indoors for now, so back to practice.
Oh,
oh, oh! Oh!
Julie, glad you could make the meeting.
Well, Kira's covering for me tonight. Just two cows left to go now, so it should be grand.
Denny's down the back, so we're just waiting on Joe now.
Grand. We should be able to keep it short tonight, just a few things to go over.
Some turn with that virus in the last few weeks.
Yeah, I missed half of it. How did it get into the country? Thought it was on the other side of the world, and they were meant to have lockdown travel out there.
No idea. My sister down in Cork said there was some crowd on a skiing holiday in Italy and half of them came back with it.
Seriously, that doesn't even make sense. You'd think the cold would kill it off out there.
I know, but I heard that the heat will do for it. So it should be gone once it warms up a bit more in the summer.
Here's hoping for a good summer then.
Hiya, Julie. You made it this time?
Yep. Made it tonight, anyways.
Sorry I'm late. Training ran over with the under-14s. They're coming on well this year. Should be a great season. We might even make the finals.
Good to hear, Joe. Sure, we'll get started so. Meeting opened 8:15 p.m. Anything to add to the agenda?
Apologies from Father Tracy. He's doing a course tonight. He asked to pass on some of the notes from the parish newsletter about an outbreak of fleas.
That's grand. Minutes of the last meeting, so.
Last meeting held the 7th of February. In attendance were Sarah, Mary, Denny and Joe. Apologies from Julie. Treasurer's report to be given next meeting. Main business, St. Patrick's Day Parade. Judges to be contacted by Sarah and Mary. Council to be notified by Mary. Clubs to be contacted to help direct traffic and for entries. Werewolf issue discussed. Volunteers to be contacted to set up a group to handle them. And Father Tracy to be contacted about holding a mass. Silver to be sourced for the next meeting for blessings. Easter egg hunt to be added to the agenda for the next meeting in 2 weeks.
Propose and second?
Propose.
Second.
Matters arising. Nora and Dermot are okay to judge the parade. Mary?
Perfect. Father Tracy said he'd be happy to judge again this year too. Should be no problem for the roads. We need to put it in the paper when the parade is running though. Started at 12 last year, so we just go with that again?
Yeah, that should be fine. We'll start by the church and finish by the GA pitch. Three judges started, so?
There's a few from the GA club to help out with the traffic too.
We've a good few groups doing floats this year too. Hopefully the weather will be good for it.
Pretty much sorted then, just need to get the notice out about it, so. The werewolves are on the agenda for tonight anyways, so we'll get to them in a minute. Treasurer's report?
No change since the last time. The funds for the village park were lodged and no payments due out for now.
Grand. So, on to the main business then. The werewolves.
I spoke to Father Tracy. He can do the mass on Friday evening. It should be lovely.
Okay, did we get any volunteers to help out?
The Macra are fairly busy this time of year, but they should be able to help around May or June, when competition's quite down, though with silage might not be great then either. They'll help out where they can.
Yeah, we've a good few from the GA. I mean, with the nonsense with the flags, we definitely want to get involved.
There were a few from yoga and the men's shed, but they want to know more first.
Well, that sounds like a pretty good response overall. How about we set a meeting for volunteers to go ahead after St. Patrick's Day?
That could work. Will we go for the Friday after?
Yeah, the hall should be free that night. The yoga group are on their midterm that week.
Perfect. So, next item on the agenda is the parish Easter egg hunt.
We might want to leave that for the next meeting. Father Tracy should be here for that one, since it's a fundraiser for the church roof.
Surely we've plenty of time to get that organised, don't we?
Okay, but maybe ask the different groups for suggestions for what we can do. We want a big crowd at it if we can, and it'll let them know that there's something being planned for it anyways. Was there anything else?
Just a notice from the parish newsletter about the flea outbreak, rampant this year apparently. Oh, and a thank you from the ladies' football for the use of the hall for Valentine's.
That was a good night, all right. Father Tracy was on point.
Well, if there's no other matters, we'll close the meeting there. Operation Transformation is on tonight, and I want to catch the end of it.
It's good this year, all right. Better than last year's crowd, anyway.
Denny, is there anyone in after us tonight?
Not tonight. I'm locking up now.
See you next time, so...
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Hey guys, did you see the news?
Yeah, the Taoiseach's announcement was just on.
I heard from Mary that the parade is going to be cancelled. It's hard to believe.
Lockdown from tomorrow. Looks like we won't be able to break the curse this year. Mayo won't see the Sam Maguire Cup in 2020 after all.
I still can't believe it. After all our hard work, we'll have to wait another year.
Even worse, all the pubs are going to be closed for the bank holiday.
We'll be back to normal soon enough. Just need to tough it out for a few weeks, then we can try again next year.
The weeks progressed and committee meetings went online as the community adjusted to the new normal. The curse remained unbroken as Mayo faced Dublin in the All-Ireland football final with an empty stadium and lost. However, the corner flags remained safe for another year.
Mail for Sam.